And while many candidates in this election will be nervously awaiting the outcome, there are some candidates on the ballot who are not worried at all. They're the ones running unopposed. Our Michael Gibson tonight takes a look at why that happens sometimes.
Every election cycle seems to have its list of exciting races, and usually those contests feature candidates from either the Republican or Democratic parties. But sometimes there's only one person who files for office, and they end up as the only name on the ballot. That happened this year in Nueces County in races like the tax assessor collector and for the 214th District Court, where Republican Judge Ina Klein had no opponent. We asked the political director for the Nueces County Democratic Party how this could happen in such an important race.
Yes, there is some form of recruitment from the party. But, you know, to be a candidate on the ballot, it's got to come from an individual, and you've got to want it, and you've got to have that desire to serve the public. You know, because at the end of the day, you're a public servant when it comes to being on the ballot.
Over in San Patricio County, the only name on the ballot for sheriff is Oscar Rivetta. He did face a challenger in the Republican primaries, but after that victory, he was done campaigning.
Because you really are bipartisan. You handle the matters, no matter whether Republican or Democrat, you handle it equally across the board.
Another important position over in Clayburgh County is the district attorney's job. John Hubert is the Republican incumbent who did face a challenger back in 2016. This time around, though, the Democrats did not have a candidate to go up against Hubert.
The party can try to recruit candidates. I know 4 years ago, the DA was contested. And of course, the Democratic the nominee was unsuccessful, and no one came forward this time. So, I mean, what can you do? It is what it is.
Luckily, on the whole, most races are contested, and these experts agree that that's a good sign for democracy. Michael Gibson, 3 News.